Hello everybody, I'm Sneaksy Gamer and welcome back to Path of Exile. Ooh. Now in the last one, I left off in here. I have a feeling there's going to be a boss fight in here. Maybe not. Hopefully not. Because I know a boss fight I won't survive. Now this is where we fought. Well, not this part, but the part I'm heading to is where we fought. Was it Innocence? Was that what it is? I don't remember. Whoever it was that was embodying Innocence. I don't remember who it was. Or maybe it was just Innocence. I don't remember. Or was it Innocence? I don't remember, because there was Sin, which we see outside, and then there was his brother, was the one we fought in here. I feel like I'm doing better than I was before. A window shard? That's just weird. Okay, one moment, please. Oh yeah, I forgot this doesn't pause when you hit the pause button. Hopefully I'll be safe here for a moment. I had to take some insulin. My blood sugar was a little high. The critical strike chance is lucky? What does that even mean? Now, if I remember correctly, his face was pretty big, too. Yeah, those guys did a bit of damage. Pretty much everything does a lot of damage in it at this point in the game, though. Okay, I knew there was a stairway over here, I just didn't know if it led anywhere. Apparently not. That's probably where I'll come out after I get the staff. Really not feeling as challenged as I used to. Either something they did in an update or something I did in those changed passives has helped me out a bit. I know I was trying to get a better weapon, but as of right now, I don't think I really need one. Seem to be doing okay so far. I've got to be pretty low on inventory space at this point. Wait a second. Ah, I see. Over there. This way. Man, that was close. I spoke too soon. Wrong one. Wrong one again.
Hello.
I feel like I might sneeze.
Remember, we do this for freedom.
Do I have any prophecies active right now? And our father, the great Kitava, will split us under the rocks of the earth, pulling himself out of the miry clay. He shall lay a banquet table before us, and we shall feast on his divine bounty, the Holy Book of Hunger by High Priest Utula. Yay. That sounds lovely. Am I gonna have to fight that guy in here? Or did I already fight? I think I already killed him, actually. Guess not. I thought I found him outside there somewhere. must be thinking of someone else then. Or no, it just wasn't a quest, I don't think, is the thing. I'm assuming this is the way forward. Those ones. This was not the way forward this time. I know I have been trying to get that one achievement by changing those, trying to get the jack that I've got. I was trying to change one of these into that so I'd get the achievement for, what is it, creating a unique by using a whole chance or something like that, I don't remember. Because that's the only item I can guarantee when I'm out and about like this without having to look back in my stash. That's the only item I can guarantee can turn into one of those things. A unique, whatever they're called. This looks like it might be leading forward, so let's head back over here then. course it's just gonna loop right over into that area. It looks like I'm full.
Yes?
Do I have any orbs of chance left, though? Because I know I have been running low. Got 4. More on that one.
What do you need?
Freedom comes to those who fight. Remember, we do this for free.
I think that's gonna lead me to where I'm supposed to go, so I wanna come back and investigate the rest of this. A little bit stuttery. It's smoothed out now, but for a moment there it was stuttering a bit. Gouger. I still say that sounds horrible.
Yes?
Behemoth Curtain, General's Brigadine.
For freedom.
I'm trying to remember how I got an Orb of Chance. I don't remember the vendor recipe for it. Yeah, I'm gonna have a boss fight in here, aren't I? I almost got him, actually. Damn.
Freedom comes to those who fight.
Yeah, I definitely improved something.
Freedom.
I knew that's where I was going to come out afterwards.
I fear I have not been entirely honest with you, my friend. While it is true that this staff can forge a path for us through Kitava's horns, it has the ability to revitalize innocence into waking fully. And that is where the staff's true power resides.
Of course.
In this act, I will become his host in the fullest sense. And together, he and his brother Sin will be able to ally with you against the forces of darkness. I bid you farewell, Exile. For where my spirit is set to travel, there is no return. Win this battle. Defeat Kitava. Free our people.
Will do.
Brother, you have seen better days, I am sure, but for now you must rouse yourself. We have work to do. If ever you wish to make right the wrongs of your past, help me now. As once I asked you in the early days of mankind, do this for me, and I shall consider our quarrel to be at its end.
Go, do battle, anointed exile. Though my brother and I will aid you, I sense the universe conspires for you to be the savior of our world on this day.
Cool. She's gonna be upset.
Bannon was a man whom I greatly admired, possibly even loved. My heart is grieved to see him depart from us and journey to the home of Hinnikora. Yet, he sacrificed himself so that we might live, and stood true to his convictions. This god, this born-again innocence, fills me with unease. Though he appears repentant of his past transgressions, I do not believe he should be forgiven, nor that he should tread this earth any longer than is required.
I'm gonna have to agree with her on that one. Able to just buy an orb of chance? Yes, I was. Costs orbs of fusing for it though.
For freedom.
Gotta go to Kitava's horns now, don't I? Oh, that is gonna be one hell of a fight. I might be at the end of the game right now, I don't know. I kind of hope I am, but at the same time, I kind of hope it's not quite over yet. I remember that attack, or one very similar to that, while we were fighting, and it did a ton of damage. Entering the canals. Kill Kitava. Well, can't get much more final than an objective to kill the final boss. Guys looked kind of like Sin. Kitava is anything like the last time I fought him, it's gonna be one hell of a fight. Find out what was down the other direction at the start then. So I'm guessing that's where I'm supposed to go. I wish I would have gone over here first. Let's do this. Where did it go? Damn it, it got away. Else over here. Okay. I saw that regurgitator thing's belly hanging down right there. That was gross. I have a feeling Kitava's gonna be resistant to all forms of damage, though. Like, there's no way I'm gonna be able to just deal normal amounts of damage to this. It will resist everything, I think. Maybe not, but seems like it will be something they do. Make the final boss resistant to everything.
For freedom.
I've got so many supplies in there, but I don't have the ones I want. Iceberg map, huh? That's a new one. Well, new from the ones I knew of. Yeah, whatever that kind of magic they're using is, it does a shitload of damage to me. I do remember that when they would hit me with that. I'm just gonna call it blood magic because it looks, it's red and black and looks kind of like blood. And whenever they would hit me with that blood stuff, it always did a ton of damage. Sucks that I have to go all the way around this to get back up there. And then yet again, I have to go all the way around. Because I don't think like a teleporting skill like lightning warp would get me around that, or would get me over those blockage things. I think I'd still have to go around. Gonna have to open a portal up there before I start fighting them again. Then I can go to town. I can revive in town and come back through the portal so I don't have to run all the way over here again. Because this is just ridiculous. Oh, that time I had forgotten to activate that again. My Arctic armor, or whatever it's called. It is Arctic armor. Okay. Yeah, I hadn't looked at that yet since I started playing again, so I wasn't sure. But I remembered it properly. Okay. I remember correctly. Good. Yeah, like this. I wonder, lightning warp might get me over there, or that one with the teleport thing with the arrows, that one might get you over, something like that, but I don't have those skills, so. So I don't get that option. Let's open a portal right here. No wonder I was dying so much. There were champions or whatever the hell they're called in this game. That'll kill you awfully fast if you're fighting something that's already tough, but it's a champion or rare or whatever the fuck of that enemy. This is how it shall end. Kitava will rise and a great cloud of black smoke will cover the sky. The glorious smell of cooking flesh shall entice even the most ardent of unbelievers to the faith, and together we will celebrate and eat at Kitava's table. The Holy Book of Hunger by High Priest Utila, or whatever the fuck his name is. Yeah, it looks like that's just gonna move around.
Greetings. For freedom.
Wow. somewhere. There we are.
Let me tell you.
That's a bit more like what I was remembering this being like. Where if I wasn't careful, I'd die in a heartbeat. So maybe nothing's changed after all. Thing up there. Yeah, that's a great idea. Head into something called the feeding troll. That's a brilliant idea. I would assume I'll get another waypoint before I have to fight Kitava, but I don't know. I might be fighting him right in here. The exit to the epilogue is now open. Lovely. This is where I fight Kitava, all right? Or at least it leads me to where I'll fight Kitava. I would have thought they would give me a waypoint before I got there. Now, why would the epilogue be unlocked right now if I haven't defeated the final boss yet? Oh, those are fucking footsteps, holy shit. Well, I think I know whose footsteps those are. I gotta check something real quick here. Okay, no, there's not footsteps on this side. Oh, yes, there are. Does that mean Kitava's big enough that he's got a foot over there and a foot over here while he's walking, or just that he moved over while he was going through here? Because I can guarantee that's Kitava's footsteps, footprints, whatever. Is that a vault side area? Yep. Vault side dungeon. Yeah, why not? What? Kill Kitava. Oh no, never mind. I misunderstood. When that came up, I thought I was in the place where I had to fight Kitava, but I'm not. It changed to that because it was saying the thing about the epilogue was now open, so when I left that area, it went back to the kill Kitava one.
Greetings.
Since I'm obviously like right at the end of the game, I might just continue on and make this a longer episode.
Remember, we do this for freedom.
Hard to forget, yes. When you tell me that every time I talk to you.
For freedom.
See? Gotta go back.
Yes.
Let me double check this real quick. Thought so. I knew it was over 800 on that one, but I was pretty sure. I just wanted to double check though.
Remember, we do this for freedom.
Templar Thaumaturgist Devaro, the ecstatic, the knower of hidden things, the key to ancient wonder. In such a short time, everything has changed. This singing of the relics to me no longer pains my ears. I've read that one. I recognize that. I recognize that part. Oh yeah, I went down this way because I wanted to go and clear the rest of this path. That's the whole reason I went over to this side in the first place. Thank you. assuming to get to the part where I fight Kitava, I just gotta follow his footprints.
Freedom comes to those who fight. Freedom.
If I do get a waypoint before I run into Kitava, then I'll just pick it up in the next episode. But if I don't, then I'll just continue through and fight him. Approaching it. Almost guarantee them being right there means that it's right through that transition is where I'll fight him. Might be able to make something useful out of it. Probably not though. Okay. Looks like I'm just about ready to go in and fight the final boss. At least it put me here and I didn't have to go from the beginning, damn it. Real helpful there. I forgot to keep an eye on the items to see what sockets they had in them. I haven't been watching for ones with all six linked sockets. Holy shit.
This is it. It all comes down to this moment to finally put an end to Kitava. Go, Exile. Together, we will save humankind.
I'm gonna go to town real quick before I go in here.
Freedom comes to those who fight. Remember, we do this for freedom. Remember, we do this.
Okay. Oh, this is gonna suck. There's Kitava.
I shall strike you down.
I knew it. Kitava resists pretty much everything. Shit. Oh my god. There's no way to avoid that. Oh my god, I barely even heard him. Shit. No fair, you can fly. Sin can fly to avoid this shit. I can't. There's nowhere to go for that one. Ah, over there, maybe. Wow. I mean, I knew it was gonna be bad, but holy shit. Ah. forgot those things. I forgot he did that when I fought him before too, didn't he? How am I supposed to survive at all in here? Maybe that's the trick. You're not actually supposed to survive this fight. Did that at least take a chunk out of his health? Shit, did he just grab Sin? That one. Fuck. I need more chaos resistance, I think, but I don't know. I don't know if that's chaos damage that... Look at that. I think it's pretty much pointless to fight those things. Jesus Christ. Holy shit. I don't even see how this would be possible to survive if you've got a full party of people. I mean, I'm not the best player at this game, but this is just insane. Stand still at all in this fight. Damn it. Even that's not safe. Oh fuck, what is that? I can't even tank through it by just spamming heal either. I mean, not that I really thought I'd be able to, but... Actually had a good opening there where he wasn't hitting me for a little bit. Fuck. Well, if I can't beat him with skill, I'll beat him with persistence. Why can I avoid that sometimes and other times I can't? Is that just because of the evasion rate and stuff or what? This part sucks. Why do I have a feeling there's a part of this fight coming where he's gonna grab both of them and I'll be on my own? Spotting a few more openings as I'm fighting them, so... That shit is ridiculous, though. This whole fight is just insanely ridiculous. There's no way. There's no fucking way I'd be able to do this if I was on hardcore. Thank you. run to avoid the fire, he does that instead. I've almost got him, though. What did I say? If I can't beat him with skill, I'll beat him with persistence. And that's exactly what I'm doing. Yet. This is the hardest part of the fight, is when these fuckers come out. How the hell are you supposed to not get killed in this part? Because you don't exactly have a whole lot of room to try to hide and things around. Hey, what are you doing? Damn. That's what they were doing. You've been permanently weakened by Kitava's merciless affliction. What? Didn't that already happen to me once?
Hello.
Didn't that already happen the first time I fought him? And then it happens to you again when you fight him the next time? Really? That's a little messed up. But I did say it, if I can't beat him with skill, I'll beat him with persistence, and that's exactly what I did.
Remember.
Yeah, so what if I died a bunch? I killed him in the end. Oh, come on, really? Really?
Freedom comes to those who fight. Remember, we do this.
It's over. We emerge victorious. It was always a fool's errand, yet somehow your courage has carried us through. I congratulate you, my friend. Your world may have exiled you, but there will always be a place for you at my table. You have given humanity a fighting chance. Though darkness still covers the face of the earth, There is now a ray of light to pierce it. The insatiable appetite of Kitava has been ruined, and you are no exile. Why, you are a hero worthy of praise. May your legend live on into eternity. Come, let us return to the others. They will be needing as many hands as possible for cleaning up this city.
I can't talk to him. So we're not going back to the docks. Where are we going then?
By the light of Ramako, you did it. You, a mortal, have crossed the threshold between God and man and struck the ravenous one asunder. I'd always held out hope that you would succeed, but at night, I would stay awake worrying that perhaps that hope was a foolish dream, but you've done it. You are no longer an exile, my friend. I honor you, and I'm certain the rest of the world will honor you as well.
Points left, huh? Let's do that, because that trap is actually pretty useful.
Santa, see! That bloody sod is gone from our world! Can't tell you how many times I've heard them Karui savages gibbering in fear over that cannibal god. And of course there's this horror to account for as well. I don't think there's a man, woman, or child in the world that won't be praising your name tonight over a glass of their finest grog. Speaking of which, where's a man to go to find a little fire water around these parts?
I suspect you're about ready for a flagon of ale. And a pretty wench or swain, whatever it be that's your persuasion. The great exile of Aureath returns to a Theopolis in chaos and ends the life of a raving cannibal god. Now that's a story worth the songs of many an ancient muse. Well, all I can rightly say is congratulations, my friend. A year ago, I wouldn't have dreamt I'd be someday soon in the company of a killer of gods. My advice, you better get while the getting's good and have yourself a holiday for Aureath, or Rayclast, or whoever else has need for your unique services once more.
Innocence. You see now, don't you?
Little brother, please forgive me. It's as if I have been dreaming the most horrid nightmare. And now, at last, the haze of sleep lifts from my eyes. My vision is clear. Oh, by the gods, forgive me.
It is as true now as it was when we began. You and I are of the same flesh, cleaved from the same womb. You ask for my forgiveness. I give it to you freely.
But the things I've done, the countless millions I've murdered.
There will be time for all of that later. But for now, your people need you. Horiath needs you.
No. I cannot remain here amongst these ruins. Amongst the corpses of my own making. These people. They need you, brother. And your hero. Not me.
Then what? Where will you go? What will you do?
Isolation. I shall go south. As far south as one can travel in such a fleshly form. There are things I must think on. The redemption I need plan. If my conscience decides I am worthy of such a gift.
You would seek forgiveness in the ice at the bottom of the world.
I would. Should you let me?
Go. Seek out that which you need. Find who you are. Make pilgrimage. Journey on your path, brother. Only return to us one day.
Thank you, brother.
We are all in your debt for what you've done. Oriath stands today only because of your heroism. For my part, I will continue to help you in whatever way I can. Keep your life to your own.
That was brutal. That fight with Kitava was just brutal.
I am Jun Ortoy of the Sun-Scorched Plains of Vestiri. I am investigating the disappearance of several prominent exiles. I have surreptitiously been observing your movements for some time. Scattered across the plains and mountains are small... Keep your eyes sharp.
Machines. I've already spoke to her about that.
Before Kitava tore the city apart, the Templar kept many artifacts hidden deep beneath
There's
the city
still
streets.
More to go.
The
okay.
only surviving remnants of the Templar theocracy are what they hoped to hide forever. I think it's time to pull back the veil. There's an entrance to the Templar laboratory not far from here. My father used to sneak me inside as a child. He never could stand the long work days apart. Come, there's something I think you need to see.
Oh, this is where I get the map device thing, isn't it? Where I can use those maps. I'm pretty sure that's what that is where I can use the maps. Yep, there's the map device that I can use to open those map things I've got in my stash. I wonder if there's still more difficulties for this game or not. Yep, map device. Cool. Now that's something I will be using at a different time. The door is locked. Okay.
My name's Anna, but I already know who you are. I also know what you did, Exile. If it weren't for you, none of us would be standing here. There mightn't have been a here. To even stand on. This map device is a miracle of both engineering and thaumaturgy. It's truly astounding. Given the right coordinates from a map, this device can take you to places that, well, honestly, I think it's easier for you to see for yourself just what it's capable of. What lies beyond is dangerous, but so are you. Yet even the Godslayer may not be dangerous enough. Take a map and use it in this device. I'll wait for you on the other side. Stay inquisitive.
Okay. Let me check something real quick. Nope, I don't get anything for killing Kitava on here, apparently. You'd think you would. But yeah, this is something I'll explore a bit in the next episode. So that's it for this episode. Thank you everybody for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and as always, I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.